Hey everyone, I'm gonna walk you through the five ways that as a contractor, if you're undercharging for your services, you're screwing yourself and you're screwing your customer. Check it out. Hey guys, this is Logan Schinholz with Contractor Growth Network. And the idea of this video is not to show you these high level tactics. It's really more so to unveil what's really going on behind the scenes when you are insanely underpriced, and maybe not even insanely underpriced, just not charging for what you're worth. One of the greatest things that you can do is charge what you're worth, because otherwise it is a disservice to both you, but more importantly, and here's the crazy thing, your customer, right? We all think that customers, if we can do the same project for them at a much cheaper rate, we're actually helping them out big time, but a lot of times that's actually not the case. And I want to walk you through five different ways that you're actually screwing yourself over by being undervalued. And the very first thing that I want to talk about is hiring. When the margins on projects are so slim, or slim enough that you're not really comfortable with what you're doing, you're not able to hire on A players. I see this a lot in the contracting space where somebody will put out a job post, and what they're asking for is somebody who can effectively do it all, right? Where they have the experience, they have the skill set, they have the drive, they have the communication skills, they have everything that you want in somebody to work with you, and they're offering like $12 an hour. It's not actually matching up like the pay rate, because what we're doing with a low level pay rate is we're saying to somebody coming in like, hey, this is how much I value you right now. Now, if they're entry level and they have no skill set, well, that makes a little bit more sense because they don't have the skill set. And we could say, hey, look, you know, we'll pay you 12 bucks, but we're gonna step you up pretty aggressively as you get these skills. But if we're looking for somebody who can do it all already, and they have both the soft skills, but also like the hard skills of the actual job, and we're not paying them, then we're not going to attract those people. And as a result, we just need warm bodies in there. And when all we're doing is just bringing in somebody who is like able to swing a hammer, and they're able to just like do the job and nothing more, it actually affects the clients. From a homeowner's perspective, that you've got two companies, right? One is going to be a company where everybody's paid well, they're a higher end, they cost more as the company, but all their employees feel like they're being valued in this company, versus somebody who's cheap, but all their employees are really somebody like they're just temps, right? With the higher end and people that are paid well, they're gonna be way better at the actual role because they've probably been around a lot longer, and B, they're going to actually wanna be there. They understand that they're in a homeowner's home, and they candidly give a shit about everything involved in the project. So when you are underpriced, you're not able to pay the people that you need to pay to help you grow your business and do a good job. So you're actually doing your clients a disservice. The second way that you are doing a disservice to the clientele is the quality of the customer service experience. When you have more money in the bank and you have a larger margin, you can afford, let's just say from like a software perspective, you can afford stuff that's like a project management software. Whether it's like BuilderTrend or something else, you can always keep the client in the know about where everything is going in the process. You have this software that you can now show to somebody that says, hey, here's full transparency on how everything's going. Or even better, let's say you actually hired a client success rep, somebody whose job and role is to make sure that as projects are going on, it's kind of like a project manager, but it's more of a holistic sense of like keeping clients happy as far as just touching base, right? When you charge more, you can afford that because now you have this overhead, but again, you're providing a better service for your end user. So by charging them very low prices, yeah, the value for them is that you're cheap, but you're actually doing them a disservice because you are not able to give them the right customer experience. All right, number three is going to be the actual quality of the work. When you charge very cheap, a lot of times you're having to cut corners just to make sure that the project stays within those margins. Because if you're very thin and you're charging, you know, like 10, 15% gross profit margins, if you go under, meaning if something goes wrong on the project, well, now you're dipping into your own money, you're stuck. And you're screwed and you're having to scramble to figure out, how do I make sure that I don't lose my shirt on this job? So you're now finding ways to make sure that you stay right within the budget, which affects them. But if you have a little bit of wiggle room, you know, because you're charging the 40, 50% gross profit margins, it's much easier to, you know, do like little upgrades here or there if you want to. Or if something goes wrong, you're not in this panic mode because you still have these thick margins on it. So again, it's going to help the end user a lot. Number four is going to be the type of clientele that you attract. If you are cheap, you're going to attract cheap people. If you are high end, you're going to attract high end people. I can't really make it any more clear than that, but there's a certain kind of clientele that go out and buy a $5,000 used car versus a $200,000 supercar. Very different clientele. And for the $200,000 supercar, they're gonna be less likely, for the most part, to be very worried about money and finances. Because if they're spending money on this 200K supercar, they're probably doing all right financially versus somebody who is coming in with $5,000 to buy a used car. It's a very different mindset, but the type of clientele that you are actually attracting is going to be completely, completely different. And as a result, the lower end people that they're looking for a bargain, they're going to treat you like you're a bargain, which in turn, you're not going to be happy doing the project. But the high end people, it's going to be different. They're going to actually want to pay you, and they've got the money box checked off. They don't need to nickel and dime you along the way. So when you have these higher end projects for these higher end clientele, it's going to be a much better scenario. And the fifth and final way that you are screwing yourself by undercharging is the actual type of work that you're able to do. If you are very thin margins, it is now a volume game for you. What I mean by that is, think of like Walmart. Walmart is very cheap, so they either A, have cheap quality products, or B, the product is okay quality-wise, but their margins are thin, and they're the only way that they really make money is by selling a lot of it. And in your case, if your margins are thin, you have to now sell a lot of it or drop the quality. But if you're not gonna drop the quality, then the volume game is going to be there. And when you have more projects to run at the same time, that is gonna be harder to keep stuff on track. So the actual work that you're able to do is gonna have to really be very narrow. You're not able to do kitchens and baths and basements and decks, because if you're in a volume game to keep, you know, the train on the tracks, you're going to have to pretty specialize in one room, and maybe it's bathrooms. And that's great. If you just wanna be the bathroom guy, that's awesome. But now you're going to have to generate enough work to fulfill that many people wanting their bathrooms done so you can hit your numbers so you can actually make money at the end of the year. So this is a very long way of saying, look, you undercharging, we think that we're undercutting the competition, which gets us more work. We think that it's actually helping the clientele out because it's saving them money. But in reality, it is hurting the industry and it's hurting the end user. It's hurting the client because we're now not able to provide as high of quality of job as we would have otherwise. So the big takeaway here, charge more. One of the big things that we're big on here is helping you increase your prices by 20%, because that's another 20% that goes to the bottom line that you could use on hiring better people, or you could use on hiring more software, or you could just take that money and put it to your bottom line and put it towards your family, whatever you want. But you need to be charging more, otherwise you're doing yourself, the industry, and your end user a disservice. Thank you.